You've had your nice shiny new home battery installed for a while when all of a sudden there's a power cut. You think, oh, I'll be fine because of the battery, but then you find yourself plunged into darkness. So why did that happen and what are your options for keeping the lights on during a power cut? It's important to know that most home battery systems do not continue to power your house during a power cut by default. I know it sounds counterintuitive, but there is a real safety reason. Your home battery outputs power into your home, and your home's wiring is effectively connected directly to the grid. You might have heard of this being called a grid-tied installation. There are a few joins in the cables where it goes through your circuit breakers and your electricity meter, but it's effectively all the same circuit. Now, if there was a fault, let's say at your local substation, and that caused a power outage in the area, if your home battery was outputting power, then the cables right up to the point of the fault would still be live. Anyone working on fixing the fault could be in danger of getting a shock. So what your battery's inverter does is continually monitor the grid to make sure that there is power, and when it detects an outage, it will shut itself down. This applies to solar inverters too, which is why most solar installations also won't work in a power cut. This is actually a requirement under EREC G98, where there are many conditions on what they call interface protection. So if battery inverters are designed to turn off during a power cut, then how are you supposed to keep the lights on? Well, it really depends on whether you want a whole home backup, so everything in your home stays powered on like nothing happened, or whether you want a partial backup just for specific circuits like just your lights or just your internet router. And even then, there are options within options. So let's break it down a bit and start with an easy one, the whole home backup. The most common way to get a whole home backup is to install something called a gateway. This usually sits between your home's power circuits and your electricity meter. If it detects a power cut, then it will throw a relay switch inside it that physically isolates your home from the grid. Your battery, and quite often the solar inverter too, can continue to power your home as needed until the gateway detects that the grid is back up and running. At that point, it'll throw the relay again and reconnect you. This can all happen within milliseconds, and you probably won't even notice that there was a power cut. This does require special hardware, so the battery inverter and the gateway must be able to communicate with each other and be specifically designed for this purpose. You have probably heard of the Tesla Powerwall, which can do this, as well as the Give Energy All-in-One and Gateway that I have got. And there are a number of alternatives too, such as the Siginstore and its Energy Gateway. You have to pay careful attention to the power output of your battery though, because if you go over that limit during the power outage, then the inverter will probably shut down and you'll end up in the dark too. In the case of my Give Energy All-in-One, that is 6 kilowatts. Provided I don't turn on everything in the home at the same time, I should be fine, but you do need to be very aware of your inverter's limit. But what if you don't need whole home backup though, or you've already got a battery system installed and don't want to rip it out and replace it with an expensive gateway compatible one? Well, the alternative is something called EPS, or emergency power supply, and there are so many ways of setting this up that it gets complicated very quickly. So let's start with a simple example and build on that, and somewhere within these examples you'll hopefully find a scenario that works for you. So we have your battery's inverter connected to your home's wiring like normal, which is in turn connected to the grid. I'm showing a Give Energy inverter here because I know that they support the emergency power supply feature, but there are many other brands that also support it, so you should check the specifications of your inverter to be certain. Usually there will be wiring terminals on the inverter labelled EPS, and in the simplest possible EPS installation, you could have a regular power socket connected straight to those terminals. If there was a grid outage, then those sockets stay live, provided you have enough charge in the battery. Again, I need to remind you to check the maximum EPS power output of your inverter. Normally, this is not as much as a whole home system, so you might be limited to 2.5 kilowatts. If you go over the limit, then your inverter will probably shut down. Instead of a socket, you could have entire circuits connected to the EPS too, such as your lighting circuit, so they'll automatically stay on during a power cut. But the problem with that is, the more you add to your EPS, the more likely you are to hit that power limit. So one of the solutions to this is something called a manual transfer switch. With a manual transfer switch, or MTS, all of your power circuits connect to the grid like normal, and when there's a power outage, everything cuts out like normal. You can then walk around your house, unplug or turn off any high-powered items, then turn the MTS, which will connect your circuits to the EPS output of your inverter instead of the grid. Because you have made sure that you have turned off any high-powered items before switching over to the EPS, you should hopefully be able to avoid overloading your inverter. But of course, the disadvantage of this method is that you are in the dark until you have turned the MTS. And importantly, you have to make sure that your inverter's main power supply is on the grid side of the MTS, or you could end up with a melted brick. Now, of course, you can keep going on this and make it as complicated as you like, maybe having the light circuits always on the EPS, but other circuits on an MTS, or many other combinations. It really is down to your own personal requirements. So what about solar generation during a power cut then? Because if the power cut happens during the day, it would be a lot better to use the power from your solar panels than drain the battery in case you need that later on when it starts to get dark. Well, if you have a hybrid inverter, then it's very simple. Your panels and battery are connected to the same inverter. So for most brands of hybrid inverters, the power from the panels is transferred straight into your batteries to charge them up, even during a power cut. And if you have an EPS circuit, then that solar power will be used to power that too. If your batteries are getting full and your EPS demand is low, then the inverter usually curtails generation. My all-in-one works slightly differently because it isn't a hybrid inverter, but it is still able to keep the separate solar inverter running during a power cut, and it can use that energy to charge the battery or power the whole home. If you don't have a battery though, if you just have solar panels, then you are probably out of luck. You'd need a special standalone solar installation that isn't tied to the grid. Hopefully this has helped you understand how home batteries operate during a power outage and the limitations that they have. If you didn't specifically ask your installer for the functionality to run your home during a power cut, then chances are it probably won't work due to the extra wiring required. I certainly rely on mine a lot because we get regular power cuts, so I'd say it's definitely worth considering. Anyway, don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to the channel for free to see more from me. These amazing people here are my channel members and patrons, so a massive thank you to them for supporting the channel. If you'd like to support the channel by becoming a member or a patron too, then check out the links down in the description. In return, you'll get early access to my videos and some bonus content too. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.